Welcome. Today we will discuss about inductor. This is inductor symbol. Impedance Z of this inductor is given by L omega, where L is inductance value and omega is angular frequency, which is equal to 2 pi f. If f frequency is more, omega will be more, then Z will be more. This means inductor impedance will increase if frequency is increasing. Here I have written same impedance in vector form and equal to JL omega. This is vector. Numerical value of this vector L omega is same as it was written here. Only J has come, which is vector. J is unit vector, and whenever you multiply anything by J, that will shift by 90 degree. Here I have shown one simple circuit, a battery, switch, resistor and inductor. Inductor behavior is such that it always opposes the change in current. If current is increasing, it will try to reduce the speed of increment. Similarly, if current is reducing, again it will try to reduce the speed of decrement. Now when we close the switch, in the beginning, reactor behaves like open circuit. When this is open circuit, and we close the switch, then full voltage will come here and no current will flow. Voltage and current wave shape I have shown here. At t is equal to 0, because it is open circuit, this full voltage Vs has come here, this is full voltage and current is 0. This is current, this is voltage. Then slowly current will start increasing. When current will increase, there will be a drop here. So voltage here will reduce. So voltage will reduce. And after some time, current will stabilize and this maximum current will be equal to Vs by R. That time it will not have any resistance. Surge voltage. Here we saw when switch is closed, then after some time some current flows. So this inductor will store some energy. That energy is equal to half Li square. So there is an energy here. Now suppose you want to open the switch again, then current cannot become zero suddenly because there is energy. This energy has to go somewhere. So what happens? When we open the switch, current will continue to flow through this open switch which has very high resistance. And this current multiply by high resistance, so high voltage will develop here and flashover will occur. Because of flashover, heat will generate and this energy will convert to heat energy here. Until this full energy is converted into heat energy, current will not become zero. So here heat energy also will be equal to half Li square. That is why when a switch is used for inductor and we want to switch off, then there will be a lot of burden in the switch. Flashover chances are there. Here I have connected inductor across AC load. The voltage across inductor is equal to source voltage. VL is equal to VS. Now current will flow. Here I have plotted voltage and current wave shape with respect to time. Red color shown is voltage and green color shown is current. In inductor, when we apply AC, current is always lagging with respect to voltage 90 degree. Our voltage is leading with respect to current 90 degree. Now how voltage is leading and current is lagging? See, this is voltage peak is here, current peak is here, this is voltage. Now time starts from here. As we move with time, first voltage peak will come. So we call voltage is leading because it is coming first. After some time, current peak will come. So current is lagging. So current will lag with respect to voltage and that angle will be 90 degrees. Now permanent magnet and temporary magnet. This is normal permanent magnet purchased from market. Temporary magnet. This is iron core. Above that we have made the turn. So it has become iron core inductor. When we flow a DC current, a flux will flow like this. Here also flux flows like this. If it is north pole, this is south pole, flux will flow like this. So because flux flows like this, one terminal becomes north pole, another becomes south pole. It behaves like magnet. If you put an iron piece, this magnet will attract this iron piece. Now if you switch off the switch, current will become zero, flux will become zero. So it will not behave like magnet. So it is called temporary magnet. If you close the switch, it will behave like magnet. If you open, it will not behave like magnet. If you give DC, if you have AC, then we can rectify AC to DC using four diode, then this we can give here. If you give AC directly here, then direction of flux will go on changing. Applications. One application of inductor is in relay. Just now we discussed, suppose there is an iron core inductor and we flow a DC current using a switch and DC supply, then this will behave like magnet and it will attract one iron piece. Now this is relay, this full is relay, this inner part of relay. Relay has three points, common, NC, NO. This is behave like switch. At present, when this switch open, this connection is here, so current will flow like this. When we close the switch, this will become magnet. This will get attracted this side, along with this, this also will move, and this point will come here. So now connection will be like this. So current will flow like this. This is called NC because when this is off, it is normally closed. Or normally open means, normally means when switch is open. This is open contact, this is closed contact. When we close the switch, this will come here, this will become open, this will become closed. Contactor is nothing but a relay. But much bigger size of relay of much higher rating are called the contactors. Now one more application of inductor is inductive sensor. This is DC, this is AC generator, it will be oscillator actually. This output goes to this inductor, red color. So some current flows. There will be a current sensor here. Now because current is flowing in this, there will be magnetic field like this. Here magnetic field will be there. Now when something comes nearby, then there will be a change in magnetic field. Because of change in magnetic field, this current will change. This change in current can be sensed by the circuit. One more application of inductor is noise filter. This is ferrite bead. This is some signal wire. Signal wire will go from inside this ferrite bead and one or two turn will be there. That it will go outside. This will block, this will behave like inductor and will block noise. Noise will not go from this side to this side or this side to this side. I will show this ferrite bead to you now. We have two cables, one HDMI, another one audio video cable. Both cables are having one ferrite core here. This is called the ferrite bead. One here, and the cable is going from inside this ferrite core. This we have like inductor and use as a noise filter. Difference between here and here is, here wire goes directly from the inside. Here, after going inside, it makes two turns and then goes. So this is like single turn, this is like three turn. So this is more effective. Here inductance value will be more. Another use of this inductor is variable capacitor for power factor control. Here I have shown 133 kV high voltage supply, AC. Here I have shown one wire, there will be actually three. I have shown RY, there will be one more. This will have a load. This load will not have unity power factor. To improve the power factor here and to stabilize the voltage at this point, we require a capacitor which should be variable. But variable capacitors are not available. So what we do, we put one fixed capacitor and an inductor in parallel of this. And current in inductor is controlled by thyristor, anti-parallel thyristor. Now capacitor and inductor are of opposite in nature. So when capacitor current is flowing here, and we flow inductive current also, so when inductive current is zero, full current will go here. As soon as current will increase here, this will cancel sub current here and less current will go here. So this plus this together will act like a variable capacitor and power factor is improved here. But power factor will improve, but what happens because of this switching of inductor, harmonic will generate. So another application of inductor is harmonic filters. Here what we do, we have one L and C in series and tuned. Tuned means at particular frequency, say omega 1, impedance of this and impedance of this becomes equal. And because they are opposite in nature, they will cancel out. So at certain frequency, impedance here becomes very low. So harmonics of that frequency will flow here, because here impedance is low. Current always try to find low impedance path. Similarly, there will be another filter which will have tuning frequency something else. So this will filter some other frequency. Like that, there may be many harmonics here, so there will be many filters, each LC tuned for certain frequency. Today we will close here itself.